Hello, and welcome to Critical Reactions, your host, Bryan. Today we are going to be looking at a Norwegian metal band called Leprous off of the album Pitfalls. The song is called The Sky is Red. I am filled with excitement for this one. I don't listen to Norwegian metal at all. I probably should, but I there's only so many hours in a day, you know, and this is an 11-minute song, 11 and a half minute, and other than that, I know nothing about this, and that excites me. This could be a very terrible decision to subjugate myself to 11 minutes of something I have no idea could be very bad. Or this could be one of the most enlightening experiences I ever have listening to a masterpiece for 11 minutes like we did with Reptile last week. So, let's get into this. Leprous, The Sky is Red. I think that's a guitar. Yeah, that's definitely a guitar. I wonder if the first was just a modulated guitar. We have a very unique time signature, though. Trying to find one. I'm trying to find what our time signature is here. That's definitely one. We're in something close to 18-4, 19-4. It's probably a better way to count that. Probably moving it into eighth notes rather than quarter notes, but... and then it's probably a split time signature. If it is 19-4, it would probably be something like 10-4, 9-4 alternating. All right. Started out with the Frank Sinatra type singing, and then moved into power metal. Something like a Danzig almost. This guy's charisma is infectious though. Like, for me, it sounds a little, I don't want to say funny, but unusual, probably due to his accent. But he just has so much bravado. He just goes into it knowing he's got this, and he's just nailing these notes. Very groovy. Even though it's an odd time signature, you just fall into this groove. I would love to see these guys do this live, because there is a lot of space, especially between the guitarists' notes. You know, they hit a note and then they're waiting, you know, half a bar later to hit the next one. And they're coming in perfectly, and I wonder how much of that is engineered, where they just lined it up, and how much of it is the fact that these guys are just master time counters, and they're just so in sync with each other that they just come in perfectly every time. Because the drums are just going, they're just doing different accents. But the guitars are just laying these real short staccato, you know, stingers, and they're all in time with each other. And that's difficult to do. See, this would be a lot easier to do since you're just always playing. You're just accenting different notes. Fire, I think that was an octave falsetto, and that was just real dirty. On top of his already, you know, higher head voice moving into falsetto range. Almost has a roboticness to it, and that's impressive. I wonder if there's any like digital modulation on that, if he's using any pedals or anything in his audio workstation, or if that's just the way that his two notes are creating a robotic, you know, roboticness. I don't have any other way to describe that. I just want to take a moment while we're a little calmed down. No, the drummer is killing it. His ability to just keep time and hold the band together so far. And it's not an easy riff. I mean, either. You got your accents that are just all over the place. They're syncopated accents. And then, you know, just being real steady this whole time. Not dragging, not speeding up, just human metronome over there. I was waiting for that. When you leave that open gap like that, you gotta come in heavy. You gotta drop that. Interesting solo. Has a very 70s, 80s rock vibe to it, rather than the shredding I was kind of expecting from the prog rock vibes that I was getting from the beginning of the track. And the thing is, even though a lot of this isn't sounding too complex outside of the time signature, there's a lot of little intricacies going on in both the drum work and the guitar work that makes this very difficult to play. I can imagine that that syncopated riff that they just got done using was very difficult to master well enough for recording. I think I'm getting a little loud here. I turned it down a bit. What instrument is that? I mean, immediately I'm going to something electronic, just because of the way the attack and decay works, but I don't have an encyclopedic knowledge of real instruments. There could very well be something out there that sounds like this. It just has a very unusual attack pattern. I mean, I guess you could probably emulate this with different embouchure techniques on a woodwind. Something reed based would get you that warm sound, and then you just have to use very rigid airflow to give you that wow, wow. You could probably do that. My guess, though, is that it's a reeded instrument. I'm getting some heavy clarinet vibes, but it's probably not a clarinet because it sounds a little too bright. But I would not be surprised if this was a, you know, a sister instrument or a cousin instrument to the clarinet. Even right here, though, going back to the syncopation, these two musicians, assuming that this is a live instrument, are, you know, almost perfectly hitting these notes in time. And that is something I would love to see live, because that's difficult to do, just to get in sync. I mean, you basically have to have two human metronomes. There's nothing keeping time here. Oh, I take that back. There is a hi-hat being hit, but it's real light. This part is kind of hitting me like the part in Periphery's Reptile near the middle, where it's definitely there to set a mood, but it's not progressing enough for me or substantial enough as it is to not make me just want the next section to come up. And I guess in a sense it means I'm getting bored already, but I kind of hate using that terminology. I don't want to say I'm bored of a section or bored of music. I'm just wanting the next... I'm ready for the buildup to be over. You know, my anticipation has reached the top of the roller coaster, and I'm ready for the fall, and it just ain't there yet. Alright, we bring the chorus in. Interesting rhythmic pattern. Oh, we're bringing this guy back. I probably shouldn't have looked at the time left, because now I know it's almost over, and that kind of ruins it, I think, for a first time listen. That's my fault. I got curious. Alright, so, there's really not much singing in this, which I like. You know, definitely when you have rock and metal bands, you know, the singer typically gets a lot of time to be the front person. And I, you know, there's probably a lot of psychology behind that. People prefer to have something they understand in music, and words are things that everyone can understand. Singing is something everyone can do, even if you can't do it well. So, you know, there's probably a reason why singers get the most attention in bands. But I really enjoy when a group says, okay, you know, I can't make this music without you guys. You're just as prominent of a member as I am. You know, we're going to give you some time to shine. You know, Tool is really big on that. Metallica is really big on that. And I'm glad to see, at least in this track, I don't know if this is normal for them, but, you know, the singer definitely had his time to just show what he's made of, and he did that fabulously. But, dang, lost my train of thought. Anyways. Yeah, he did that fabulously, but then he, you know, he let the song breathe. He let the instruments have room to flex their muscles and say, you know, this is what we're doing. You know, we are real big on time. We're all metronomes. Let us show you some really fancy stuff we can do with time modulation and playing syncopatedly. And let us introduce you to new feelings and new ideas through the music. And, you know, that's not so much of a statement in metal music. There are a lot of bands that let the music really drive it. But it's still an impressive, almost brave thing to do in 2019 when so many songs are 2.5-3 minutes, and 2 minutes and 45 seconds of that is singing. There's barely any time to appreciate the music or the musicians or the musicianship or the composition or anything outside of the lead singer. So, I mean, the singer stops singing maybe about the 4 or 5 minute mark. The last half of the song, Easy, was instrumentals. So, you know, I have to appreciate that. I will appreciate that anytime I hear it. Anytime a lead singer steps out of the way and lets the band shine for a little bit, that makes me happy to know that, you know, the band doesn't the lead singer doesn't see himself as the leader of the band. He's, you know, another instrument, another part of it. So, yeah, that's cool. But the song itself, I dig. I will be checking out more of this band. If you guys want me to react to that, let me know. Otherwise, I will be checking them out on my own because this is something I am personally interested in. I need more of this Leprous in my life. And unfortunately, I was so caught up in the musicality of the song, I didn't catch many of the lyrics. I heard him say the sky is red once. But I was real honed in on the music, the time signature, the syncopation, you know, just the real musicianship of it, and even the musicianship of the singer. His techniques, the way he just had all that confidence, just belting out those notes like they were nothing, and the way that he layered and harmonized the vocal track to create different textures. I know that might be a strange word. Most people think of textures as a physical thing. But I don't know if this is normal. I feel musical notes. I feel chords. Even just two notes together have a feeling to me. So I've always said that music has textures. It's a word I've used. I've adapted it from its physical use to an auditory use. And if you don't understand what I mean by that, it's just that I guess we could prune it down and say that the way that he used the notes together have characteristics to them, auditory characteristics that gave them unique identities, and they sounded interesting together. And that's definitely something I got with his layered, the upper head voice almost going into a falsetto, layered under the falsetto that he put on top of it. There was something very cold and robotic about it. It had a bit of, there was almost some dissonance to it. It wasn't a perfect octave. I think it was an octave. It wasn't perfect, though. And it caused a little bit of warble in there. And I have to say it was intentional because it gave off such a mood, and it fit with the, you know, the slow chug of the song. And the whole time I'm just thinking that, you know, there's something coming, and it's coming slow, but it's going to be devastating. You know, we're talking about a big super bad guy or a storm or some powerful force, you know, slowly making its way towards the singer, towards the protagonist of the story, whatever. And that part in the middle that I felt was moving a little slowly for my tastes works well in that metaphor, though, because it's the gradual buildup. You know, that force is getting closer and closer and louder and more powerful, and it goes from being something you hear off in the distance, you know, just a war drum and a wind instrument, to this big booming presence that you can't help but notice. There's no way you can ignore this anymore. It is taking up everything in your vision, and going to the song, it was taking up all the auditory space. There was no silence. There was no room for growth. It was a very wide sound filled with a lot of different instruments. And, you know, sound textures, the whole song to me was just a mood. And, that's, again, I love it. I will probably end up checking out the lyrics to see if what I felt is anything like what the song was about. But I will have to take this in a couple more times, because it there's too much for me to grab and really, you know, as a sponge, like absorb into on a first listen. There's a lot going on here, and I will need to break this down and fully integrate this into my mind, because there is some really good stuff going on here. So what did you think? You ever heard Finnish metal before? Nope, not Finnish. Swedish. Dang. Give me a second. You know what? Forget about it. I said at the beginning. Oh, Norwegian. That's what it is. Yes. Have you ever heard Norwegian metal before? Is this your first time? Did you enjoy this? Do you want to listen to more of Leprous? Should I react to more from Leprous? If so, hit me up with some suggestions for songs. They don't necessarily have to be like this one. I don't know if this was a one-off for them, or if they typically write these long epics. But I would like to listen to more of them. And while you're in the comments, make sure you like, subscribe, ring the bell, and do anything else you need to know to let me know that I'm doing a fantastic job. In fact, you can even just let me know that in the comments. It doesn't have to be anything spectacular. It doesn't have to be a suggestion. Just say, hey, I like your work, man. And I'll be like, hey, that's cool. I like your comments, man. I do this so y'all are entertained, and I'm glad you're entertained. And that'll be, you know, that might be the beginning of an awesome friendship, or that might be just where it ends. And we just, you know, said really nice things to each other and made each other's day brighter. So, yeah, let me know in the comments. Type some things to me, and I will type some things to you. And until next time, this was Critical Reactions. Have a fantastic day.